I got diabetes when I was 4.
I was 13.
I was 23 months. I was 6.
I was 16.
The risk of developing type 1 diabetes is higher than virtually all other severe chronic childhood diseases.
Did you know?
Diabetes can lead to an increased risk of heart disease, stroke, and premature death.
Did you know?
1 in 10 people will develop diabetes.
Did you know?
Diabetes is the 7th leading cause of death in the United States.
Did you know?
Diabetes is the leading cause of blindness, kidney failure, and amputation.
Lauren lost 10 pounds in about a week and a half. And when we got home, instead of doing laundry and the things I should have been doing, I was just sitting thinking about her, and it dawned on me, oh my God, she's diabetic. When we got the confirmation from the doctor that she had diabetes, my daughter was devastated. And I just thought to myself, I have to be strong. I have to be the strong one.
At first, we were very confused by the diagnosis. There's no diabetes in my family or my husband's family. So it was one of those diagnoses that was kind of out of the blue for us.
When I first had to take injections, I was miserable. I hated needles. Every time I had to go to the doctors to get a shot, I would have a fit. So learning I had to take 5 shots a day, I was just beside myself.
At first, having diabetes was really difficult because of the injections and the shots. I've never been one for needles or blood. I've passed out every single time I've given blood. I cringe at horror movies. But after a while, I mean, it's still difficult, but I mean, you learn to get used to it and deal.
When my blood sugar is low, I feel shaky and I get a headache.
I don't like diabetes because I have to get shots when I'm super high.
The thing I don't like doing about diabetes is that I have to get 4 shots a day.
I think the biggest challenge for Haley was the fear factor and, of course, the pain.
What I like least about diabetes is having to excuse myself to check my blood sugars and not have that time that my friends do of just hanging out and being normal. I think about it 24/7. I can't escape from having diabetes ever.
Every night we used to, you know, that's a time when you want to send your kids off to bed and have them go to sleep in a sort of a calm and restful manner. And every night before bed, it meant a shot for her before she could go to sleep. And that was hard for her and for me as her mother, having to do that to her every night.
I guess I just feel self-conscious about not being like everyone else.
Camp was an amazing experience for me. When I was first diagnosed, I was alone. I didn't know anyone who had it, and I was kind of scared. I didn't know what to do. And then camp brought acceptance. There was so many people that were there telling me it was okay, I was loved, everyone knew what I was going through. And it just lifted my spirits. It just lifted my spirits and it helped me get through everything.
Camp is so important because it's the one place in these children's lives that they can come and be just like everybody else. We have some children who might be the only child with diabetes in their school. We have some children who come to camp who are the only child with diabetes in their entire town, and they're feeling so isolated and so alone. And when they come to camp and see 60 to 70, 80 other kids just like them, and they see the bulk of the camp staff just like them, you can't put a price or you can't put a value on that experience, because they know they're not alone. And they know that they see these grown adults walking around with type 1, type 2 diabetes just like them, and they'll know that they're going to be okay.
And I said, oh, you like lemonade, why don't you have some of that? And she said, Mom, I can't have lemonade. I said, Molly, you're at Camp Hamwi, that's Crystal Light. And she looked at me and she went, oh, that's Crystal Light? Everyone here's, it hit her at that moment. It meant so much to me as her mother that you could just see the joy in her face that she realized at that moment, this whole week, she wasn't gonna have to worry about anything she ate or drank. And I actually said, Molly, you're at Camp Hamwi. You can eat and drink anything they're serving you here, you can have. And that was a great moment for us.
I think it was the first time since her diagnosis that she really was around other children her age that had to go through the same, checking the blood sugar, counting the carbohydrates, getting the medicine, getting her insulin. And it was the first time I think that she felt like she really fit in somewhere completely.
Along with the traditional camping activities that we do at camp, we also do daily diabetes education. We have a three-tiered curriculum that covers a variety of education topics that include monitoring and insulin and oral medication, as well as exercise and pump management, because we've noticed over the years more and more children are coming to camp on the pump.
My fondest memory of camp would have to be all the people there. They treated me as if they know me my whole life. They were so kind, so accepting of me, and I felt loved.
But at the end of the week, the first thing out of her mouth when we went to pick her up was, next year I get to stay up till 11 o'clock because I'm going to be with the big kids. So she obviously had a great time because her first thought was, I can't wait till next year and here's what I get to do. So Camp Hamwi was a wonderful experience for her and really meaningful to me and my husband.
We have a mission at the Central Ohio Diabetes Association that no child is ever turned away due to financial difficulties.
Did you know?
There is currently no way to prevent type 1 diabetes.
Did you know?
Type 1 diabetes is an autoimmune disease that usually occurs in children and young adults. There's no cure.
There's no cure.
There is no cure. There is no cure.
There's no cure.
Diabetes claims a life every 3 minutes, and without your support, that life could be my daughter's.
Start now.